In the last 3 years, fatal training accidents have taken the lives of 4 times more service members than our enemies have in combat. This cannot continue. Unfortunately, this is an issue of command. There's plenty of blame to go around for the deteriorated state of our military, and we cannot ignore Congress's responsibility. Years of budget cuts, continuing resolutions, and sequestration have forced our military to maintain a high operational tempo with limited resources. We know that has come at the cost of training, maintenance, readiness, effectiveness, and the lives of too many brave young Americans. Our service chiefs, including the Chief of Naval Operations, have testified repeatedly that the Budget Control Act and sequestration are endangering the lives of our men and women in uniform. My dear friends, we were warned.
But make no mistake, sir, while these factors do exert a negative force on the challenges we face, at the core, this issue is about leadership, especially command. Our first dollar, our first molecule of effort, our first team must go to safety. Safety is first. And no matter what the situation, those charged with command must achieve and maintain a standard that ensures their teams are trained and ready to safely and effectively conduct assigned operations.
Mr. Chairman, I don't know what caused the tragic recent accidents, but I do know from my work that the Navy's caught between an unrelenting operational demand and a limited supply of ships. At this point, I'm skeptical that the Navy will be able to make significant readiness gains unless the demands on them are decreased. Even with increased funding going forward, my assessment agrees with the Navy that it will take several years to rebuild training, manning, and maintenance, foundations of readiness that have become shaky over time.
Over the past 9 years now, you know, looking over as we review the data, the number of efficiency studies, effectiveness studies, can you do more with less? They all result in a constant pressure to, it rarely results in an increase. We are reviewing every single ship, ship by ship, to evaluate their material and operational readiness. That is being done both administratively to make sure that our certification process is good, and also with physical visits.